Hey guys, this is Kay. Welcome back to Demon Souls. The first little bit of this video is actually done in post commentary, like only about 5 minutes or so, and then it goes live. And I'll explain why as soon as Blacksmith Ed over here is done talking.
If it be a blacksmith, then show me some coin. The soul of a demon is an inferno of wrath.
So I was just sort of routinely returning to the blacksmith, and I wasn't recording live commentary because it was loud. And I didn't expect anything interesting to happen, but actually two things did. So, first of all, you saw that little bit of dialogue there where he said, like, the soul of the demon is an inferno of wrath or something like that. There was actually one or two lines of dialogue before that that I don't have on footage. But essentially, it sounded like he was saying that he needed an ember, like something to make the flame bright, so that he can like get the power out of the demon souls or something. So it sounds to me like he's a boss weapon creator, and I need to get him one or more embers. The other thing was I had come with a variety of weapons because I was looking for something different to use. And you can see all of these various upgrade paths that this blacksmith offers and the other doesn't. So there's stuff like quality and crushing and dragon. And the sharp path here, you can see it on the Uchikatana, it looks like a good dexterity scaling, which interests me a lot. So crushing is kind of the equivalent, like, strength scaling boost. Quality I still haven't really figured out. It kind of looks bad. It looks like it's just worse than upgrading along like the regular like sharpstone hardstone path. And then there was also on one of these weapons, which one was it? There was a tearing upgrade on one of them, which looked like it added a bleeding bonus to the weapon and like a small dexterity bonus, but not as large as the sharp upgrade path. So I tried out a couple of weapons. I was looking for a weapon to do like a dexterity upgrade on, and I picked this S-stock because it has a push and seems like a dexterity weapon. Unfortunately, it's got the kind of poking attacks only, but I'm ready for a change of weapon, so I'm going to take this S-stock up the sharp path. I didn't have enough souls for it, so I went soul farming around this level for a little bit, got like 2,000 souls, and then upgraded this S-stock to, I think, sharp plus 2, maybe? Plus 2 or plus 3. Yeah, there's the tearing upgrade. I was also considering maybe using the katana, but I don't yet have the strength for it, so I went with the S-stock. So that uses Bladestone, and I think I was getting Bladestone in World 4, I guess, in the Shrine of Storms. Those skeleton enemies were dropping them. So there you go. I'm going to now return you to live commentary in a moment. So I'm just, I took the sharp S-stock now as my primary weapon, and then I left the Crescent Falchion as the secondary weapon because I've been running into enemies where it does a lot more damage than the pure physical. Okay, we're back to live commentary here. All is quiet. So now, with my newly upgraded sharp S-stock, I'm gonna go back to the second world and continue on from the Armor Spider Archstone. A dragon's grave is said to lie in the lava-filled innermost area. Sounds wonderful. Let's go there. Okay, that's where I came from. So here is progress. What I got for stuff. Let's get rid of these. Those. Oh no, I don't need the poison items because I have the spell. I did off camera, I got rid of the soul arrow spell. So I'm only going through the two spells now. Let's put the knocks on. Yeah, those will do. Looks like Crystal Lizard. It's definitely a Crystal Lizard. So maybe I should do Thief Ring. See if I can sneak up on it. And use the Crescent Falchion, because I seem to be able to hit with these kind of curved swords. That guy is surely going to attack me because he has glowing eyes, but we're going to go all out for the lizard. Oh, I missed it. Oh, shoot. No. Oh, damn it. Oh, that backstab killed me. Or saved the lizard. Oh, I had it. Ooh, I get another chance. Okay. That would have worked. I just needed to not get myself into a position to do a backstab on someone. That was terrible. Oh, come on. Oh! Darn it! Oh, God. Oh, it died! And so did I. I feel like if I had clicked the button as I fell past it, I might have been able to grab that item, because the prompt came up. Alright, well. That looks like it. No more lizard. So that was failure. Complete and utter. Pardon me. I'll just be stabbing you in the back. Okay, I can't turn the rails. Is that Shredder? Oh god, it's an explosion. Like it has a tremendously large radius. So what material are they transporting that just blows up? All right, let's deal with you guys. Lizard preventers. See your bag. Any goodies. Ooh, hardstone chunks. sharp stone chunks. Weird hallway. Massacred their entire people. I suppose that lizard treasure is still down there. It doesn't look like it. What was it I just rolled through there? Looks like a bug. It's like the hardened, molted carapace of a bug. Like a caterpillar. Sharpstone. Uh-oh. Let's do this. Where am I to go? Can I? That looks too far to roll. Probably. Maybe I could roll like up on the wall. And there is a ledge. Like way down there, but that could be too far. That could be death. Am I missing anything? You see any other ledges? There's one over there. Again, it looks too far. I think my best bet might be trying to roll along this wall here. Nope. Nope. All right, so we've got a jumping puzzle going down into a very deep pit that has all sorts of treasures on the way down. And we also have this route over here. Past the exploding carts. This guy dropped something. It's rare. Two sharp stones. Oh, they can drop. They can drop upgrading materials. I shouldn't run in the same direction as the cart. I should run past it. Okay, let's go exploring. I wonder if there's like a weak wall somewhere that you can get those to blow up as it goes down the tunnel. Oh, hello. Haha, Yes, drop me healing items. I'm getting low. It's like another lift. So they're giving me a way down here. A way down that way. Let's keep going. Claustrophobia-inducing tunnels. Fire spinning. Worm doesn't have much of a radius. Seems like it only does this one move. Ooh, that did nothing. Let's try this sword. That's much better. Thing. Can I pick it up? Guess I have to pick it up from here. An ore used to make weapons that use sheer power to bludgeon things, so I think that's like better strength scaling. And sharp stone is better dexterity scaling. But only for certain types of weapons, like certain weapon classes. Whoa! Just one-shotted it. Get this one. Yes! Hard stone, clear stone, chunk of clear stone. Oh, so many treasures. But surely I die if I go off of here. Ooh, maybe not. That doesn't look too far down. It's pretty far down. Oh. Okay. Wait, this level is loaded with loot. There's some. That definitely looks droppable. Splinters, clear stone. Let's go here. Gray stone. Thank you. and I have no way up. Chunk of gristmill. I've got no way to get back up there. A large axe, a cleaver. Similar to an axe, it is very versatile, but it's too heavy to wield with ordinary strength. Using that weight, this weapon blows enemies away. The effect of a critical hit is also larger than that of a standard axe. It's got 26 strength requirement, 130 base damage, which is pretty good. One of the biggest I've seen, if not the biggest. 10 pounds. Apparently a critical bonus. Oh, so much life. Okay. I really missed the plunge attack. These things. To do proper exploration, you have to get rid of all the baddies. I guess I shouldn't call these guys baddies. I'm totally, like, invading their invading their territory. Of enemies. Oh god, what is that? This caterpillar will self-destruct in. Lizard. I guess this is the level you go to if you need upgrade materials. There's so many ways to go. Goodness. Every enemy drops them. They're littered all over the place. What's this one doing? It's like it's about to tumble. Let's take a tumble. Safe. Well, I don't really have any reason to kill it, except, is it blocking a path? Yeah, it's not. Uh-oh. These are the levels that are really hard to go through kind of methodically. Because there's so many different routes. Alright. Let's kill it. Because I know they drop items. Club. Bashing damage? No. A poison. No. There we go. And have a bleeding. Worth it. Dragonstone. Ring of flame resistance. Already had it. Okay. Let's put the Estoc back for the regular guys and the Crescent Falchion for everything else. Right now, my strategy, because I'm completely lost, so my strategy is just kind of locate a glowing treasure and run toward it, and then repeat that until I don't see anymore. Right now. No obvious way up, so let's head down toward these ones. And I guess I'll explore these tunnels last. We have some kind of like, is this a bee? I guess they're all derivations of the same creature. They all drop Dragonstone. Which is fire damage. Gone too far. Treasures above. Yeah. Nope. Still missed. I have a feeling I'm going to be cutting out a lot of this footage. I mean, I'll leave in all of the item gets, but cut out some of the fumbling around on platforms. Oh god, I missed it. Wait, what was talk? Who am I talking to? Oh god, there's a guy there. Totally blended in. Look at that. Let's not fight right next to the guy I can talk to. Lava. I don't want to get into a situation where I'm surrounded by these things. Keep coming. Okay, let's go back up here, try to get that item, and then talk to this guy. I have to, like, hit that board right there. There we go. Dark heater shield plus two. Worth it. The heater shield is 100 physical. This has less hit resistance, but more magic defense. You look like you might be...
Remember me? I've got plenty of wares. So bring me plenty of souls.
See? It's the same guy that was, right at the Stonefang entrance. Oh no, does that mean he's moved down here? It's kind of nice having him up there. Oh, he sells large splinters now, though. I don't actually remember what I need, but I probably need some of these. And I probably will need some of these. Let's buy one of these, too. Some more of this. There we go.
Have you heard? Deep below this mine, there's a dragon shrine filled with dragon bones. Well, according to little Skirver anyway, I'm not about to go and find out. Those bear bugs scare the living daylights out of me.
Is that what these are? Bear bugs?
Have you heard about that sparkling lizard? He's not easy to catch, but he's got some fine stones, and I know where his nest is. Oh, I'm sorry. I can't give it away. Those bedbugs scare the living daylights out of me.
Okay. Well, hello, a there. Large shard vendor. Very, very useful. So he talked about there being a dragon shrine. That sounds familiar. Are they petrified dragon bones? We'll keep heading down toward the lava. Worms drop greystone, which is strength scaling. The possibly bear bugs drop dragonstone, which is fire scaling. And the lizards seem like they drop sharp, hard, clear. All I can remember seeing. Alright, so this has got to be progress. So let's go explore those tunnels first. I am well and thoroughly lost. I have no idea where the archstone is from here. I mean, I know it's up somewhere. These are, no, those are probably bear bugs, because they're, you know, bugs. Clear stone. God, so many materials. Death pit. So, about what that blacksmith said. I don't actually know what I'm going to say in the post-commentary, so... I wish I had caught the first couple of lines. But he said something about... the demon soul is basically an ember. Like, in both Dark Souls 1 and Dark Souls 2, you had to collect these embers for the blacksmiths so that they could do, like, special upgrades. So I'm thinking I'm gonna get, like, a basically an ember. Maybe it'll be called something different, but he talked about the demon souls, like the wrath of the demon souls, burning like a hot flame, like an ember. I guess an ember isn't really... Oh, no! No! Oh! Bah! Not gonna get that one up there. Maybe I can get this one. Oh! Good God! No! Holy crap! It's a trap. Well, that works. Hello. didn't drop treasure. Totally did, didn't I? Don't back off the ledge. Don't. Do it. Oh, no. No. Oh, wait. It's a lift. Come on, be a lift that goes down. There's little pinpoints of treasure down there. Oh, what a sad day. It's gonna go up, isn't it? Oh, guys. I missed treasure. I can see it. It's probably good. It's probably special. I'm actually tempted to throw myself down there and try to, like, grab it right before I die.